Winter snow means our alfalfa stands are undercover, and that is a good thing until we get to spring. We're going to talk alfalfa this morning with Don Miller, and Don is Director of Product Development with Alpharex, where you get a high-gest 360 low-lignin alfalfa. And Don, here we are, the last day of February. Hopefully we've got some well-established stands to work with. Management is required, though, to get well-managed and well-established stands, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And I think as we move into this new production year, I think we need to go out there and make sure that we have everything lined up to get the maximum yield and quality out of those fields. And so in your established stands, hopefully the last couple of years you've picked and planted a high-quality variety like the high-gest alfalfa that we have. But with that in mind, we need to go out there and check and see what the fertility is of our fields this spring, make sure that we can maximize the genetic potential of varieties out in the field. So you need to go out there as soon as it thaws and you're able to get a soil sample, check that soil fertility and then fertilize to needs. Manure is always a good resource to put fertility back into that field. But again, you need to check that fertility out there and make sure that everything's in line as we move into the spring production year.
Are we talking about getting this fertility up to snuff before that first cut or after the first cut, Don? How soon?
Well, I think you need to know where you're at, and if you can put some manure out there, that'd be great. But again, you just don't want to be deficient going into that production season. And for each ton of alfalfa that you removed last year from that field, you removed 15 pounds of P2O5, 60 pounds of potash, 5 to 8 pounds of magnesium and sulfur, and a half a pound of boron, and 100 pounds of lime. So you're mining the nutrients out of that field as you harvest alfalfa out there, so eventually you need to replace that. And so that, if you are deficient out in the field, a low P and K affects the stand persistence and production, and you really need to make sure that everything is in line to maximize production this coming year.
Don, as we get these stands a little bit older, we get a little grass that works its way in there. Does that change the fertility requirements?
Yeah, even the farmers that have alfalfa grass mix, you need to be aware that the grass has a very fibrous root system, and so that grass can scavenge the soil nutrients a lot more efficiently than the alfalfa can. So if you've got an alfalfa grass mix out there, be aware that if you're just marginal on the fertility out there, the grass is going to get that nutrients before the alfalfa. The grass may not show a deficiency, but the alfalfa will be in a deficit situation if fertility is minimal out there in the field.
So again, you got a stand established, manage it well, and that means the proper fertility rates so you can manage that stand for maximum milk per acre. Thanks, Don. Don Miller with us once again. Don, again, Director of Product Development with Alpharex, high-gest 360 low-lignin alfalfa.